you are saying they have arrested Babu Owino. I believe that you had not completed processing the bail. So how have they rearrested him?
We have been chased. We went to pay cash bail there, and then we have been chased from there by anti-rack.
So without paying cash bail, it means that Babu Owino had not yet been released. Have they?
What happened is once the court has granted him the cash bail and bond terms, we go to the registry, we process, we pay. Then he is released.
We have been chased from the registry by anti-riot.
They have chased these gentlemen from the registry.
I have the cash bail here.
They have not been allowed to process the cash bail. They have whisked away Babu Owino.
While still in their custody. Because they are not...
You can imagine somebody has been whisked. And Mr. Okachi is here. He has witnessed that. Somebody was within the jurisdiction of the court. Somebody which the court has admitted to bail. Has been whisked away even without processing the bail. You can imagine where we are degenerating to. Where is the Chief Justice in this country? Where is the Chief Justice? Where is Honorable Martha Koome? Why are you allowing this to happen? Why are you allowing the courts to be defiled by police officers and by the state? Where is Maina Jenga? Why has he not been brought to court? Who is holding him? Where is he? Why can't he be brought to court? What offense has he committed that the court cannot be able to address? I believe even the devil needs justice. Why should you rearrest somebody and whisk him away even before he's processed by the court? Mr. Okachi has witnessed that.
Then it means, counsel, we cannot even call that rearrest. That is sort of an abduction.
Abduction. It's a series of abductions. I do not even think we advocates are safe. But we shall continue. We shall die on our feet and not on our knees.
Yeah. And in fact, the most important thing that you need to understand is that they are even now trying to prevent advocates in court from executing their mandate. This is our place. This is our office. This is where we work. But cops are being allowed to come and intimidate even advocates in court. It is a very dark day, and I think that's why these backstops are at the foot of Martha Koome, because she's the one who is in charge and to ensure that these courts are safe for everyone. It has reached a point where, and this is very sad for the media fraternity, we are seeing police officers, well known, coming to court and being allowed access wearing press jackets. And there is an accreditation for press people. So how do they gain access to the courts when they are pretending to be press people? There's already a very serious issue in terms of the administration of justice here. And these are the things that we are saying. It is high time that even the magistrates' court need to know that they have the power to ensure, and they are bound by Article 3, to ensure that the rights of everyone, including even yourselves, the press people, are observed. Police officers are even removing press people the way they want, and they pretend to be the press people. It is not right. You cannot be stopped from accessing the registry, and the court has said clearly here that let this cash bail and bond process be done. Because some of these people are very sick, are actually ailing based on even the grave beatings that they have received. And it's not only the second accused person. Actually, all the accused persons were actually beaten. It's only that for the second accused person, it may be more visible. So this is a point where I'm saying, people are saying President Moi was a dictator. He must be turning on his grave wondering that we have a reincarnation of even a worse regime at this particular point. But we said yesterday, we say it now. Our role as advocates will remain. We'd rather die. We'd rather be jailed. We will stand here. Whoever wants to remove us, let them come. The Constitution will fight for itself, and eventually it will succeed.
Let Chief Justice Martha Koome, and I insist, let Chief Justice Martha Koome, if she ever hears people, make sure that this place is out of bounds for police officers. We advocates, we are not here to demonstrate. Honorable Chief Justice Martha Koome, this is Advocate Degwanjiro. In the company of Advocate Okach and in the company of Advocate Asha, may we kindly address you to make sure that you make it easy for advocates to practice law within the court precincts.
Thank you.
Martha Koome, don't allow this place to be raped and defiled by police brutality. We have been brutalized this morning. We are not allowed to process cash bail for our clients. Where do we go to? Martha Koome, where do we go to? Please tell us.